There's this river of joy that is flowing in my heart. There's this fountain of blessings I'm feeling all around. Baba, oh, Baba, oh, Baba, Yashe. Baba, oh, Baba, oh, Baba, Yashe. Now who be the reason? Baba, Abba, Father, we thank you for this segment of the present help again. As always, we are in your presence, so thank you first and foremost for always helping us. Week in, week out, you have ministered to souls, you have touched lives, you have fulfilled needs in the lives of many, as only you alone, our God, can. We return all the glory, all the praises to you. As we worship this evening, come and glorify your name. We're going to exchange together, let life never remain the same. And we'll be careful to come back to you according to your word in Isaiah 42, verse 8. To return all the glory to you. As always, thank you, our Father. All glory be to you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. My hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
up on high. We exalt you. We lift you high above the constellations of heaven. Blessed be the name. We are grateful to you. We worship you. We extol your good virtue. There is no one like you, like God. There is no father like you. No one like you. You say you are the father to the fatherless. The husband to the wife. Blessed be the name. We worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Psalm 89, God was talking about his promises to David. And God is somebody that whatever he says will come to pass. If God makes a promise to you, makes a promise to you today, just go and sleep. Nothing can change it. Even the kings of this earth, they know. Do you know what? Even the devil knows. The Bible said the demons, they hear the name of Jesus and the cross, they tremble. In Psalm 89, from verse 31, God was talking. When Jesus was hung on the cross, the Bible said, when he cried unto heaven and said, Lama, Lama, Eloa, Eloa, Lama, Sabatani, the Bible said, the heavens became dark for us. The heavens, that connotes and signifies the mood swing of God. At that moment, the whole of heaven was mourning. Because a glorious event that will rescue the destiny of man, of mankind, from darkness was about to take place. And it was not an easy decision for God to make. So when Jesus gave up the cross on the cross, the entire heavens became dark. And if the heavens above us become dark, what happens to the earth? The entire earth will be filled with darkness. Praise the Lord. Verse 31, God was talking to descendants of David for posterity. And when God speaks, he does not change his word. In Isaiah 55, God said, as water comes from heaven, when rain falls and descends to the earth and does not return, says, so also is the word I speak. Say, once I speak them, they don't return to my mouth void. They must accomplish the purpose of that errand. Same way, he started speaking here for posterity's sake and for record's sake. If it were not to be on record, I wouldn't read to you today. Verse 31, he said, if the children of David, the descendants of David, if they break my statutes and keep not my commandments, then I will visit their transgression with the rod and their iniquity will strike their sins. Such as we are witnessing today in Nigeria. Occultism, diabolism is almost becoming a commonplace. No regard for human remains anymore. Kidnappings here and there. Verse 33 said, nevertheless, my loving kindness will I not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. No wonder, no matter how much men sin, if they are liable to repent and come back to the name of God, he will take them. Saddam Hussein of Iraq that was killed during the war. If that man Jesus coming to my life before he passed on, Saddam Hussein will be among those seated with Christ right now in the heavenly places. When the thief on the cross made it, he said, nevertheless, my loving kindness will I not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. Then verse 34, where I'm going, he said, my covenant will I not break. God is not a man. Men can change their words just like that. Some men don't have integrity. They tell you A, you better be expecting not even Z. They're expecting C, 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 K, K, K. If they promise you instantly, before you turn your back, it's already broken. Say, my covenant will I not break. That is the one who created me and you. Utter the thing that is gone out of my lips. friend came to greet him, and one particular one probably was around him while he was inside with the relatives. One thing or the other has changed, and then he made a promise to the young man. What do you want for Christmas? And a promise of shoe, he asked. And as soon as that boy, little boy, heard that word, he flew out of the house to his mates to boast to them and say, "Hey, I have shoes for Christmas." So another boy, not to be undone there, young boy too said, "My father promised me two shoes." Another one too spoke about the promise from the parents. But they said a particular boy spoke and said, "You, if your father promised you shoes, every one of us knew that your father is a liar. That that should promise you is a lie. You will not fulfill it. But if Baba Eko, as they were referred to my father-in-law, Pastor Eno Kadeja Adeboy, that if Baba Eko promised you shoes, it's as good as you wearing that shoe with him."
Concerning
when they say somebody is terrible, that means that person is a terrorist. God is the head of all the terrorists of the universe. When he desires to catch any one of them, it won't take him long at all. When it was time, they say Shekau had, he felt the jiggy of God's leg. He bumped himself. How much? God is powerful. His powers can be terrible. He can terrorize your terrors. Praise the Lord. Verse 2, God said, for I have said, I have spoken from my mouth. When God is speaking, one of my father-in-law pastor, you know, Academy Abbey Aribo said to me, where God is talking, he said, take cognizance of it. Don't joke with it. Drink it in. God said in verse 2, for I have said, mercy shall be built. Mercy shall be built up forever. It's mercy. There is no time to seek for God's mercy. You don't see it. All you need is to come. In Luke chapter 15 from verse 18 down to 20 something, the Bible said the prodigal said, I will now arise and go unto my father. He spoke with his mouth. His mouth was his deliverance. He has been suffering until he spoke. He said, I will now arise and go unto my father. When he spoke that to himself, his body had it. In verse 20, the Bible said, and he arose and he went to his father. And according to this verse 2, nobody was looking forward to see him. Nobody. But the Bible said, as soon as the father saw him from afar, his father was the first one to see him and ran and held his neck and welcomed him back home. He said, mercy, my mercy shall be built up forever. He said, thy faithfulness shall thou establish in the very heavens. Verse 3, say, I have made a covenant with my chosen. God have a covenant with me and you. We are not ordinary people. Our blood shall not be shed by unrighteous and unjust wicked ones. In the name of Jesus. Say, I have made a covenant with my chosen. I have sworn unto David, my servant. I have sworn unto William, my child, my son. But the devil has sworn to Eric, my son. God has sworn to Ifeoma, my daughter. Say, I have sworn. I have made a covenant with my chosen. I have sworn unto David, my servant. Verse 4, said, thy seed will not establish forever. Ah, God will establish the seed of William and Daphne forever in Jesus' name. And build up your throne to all generations. Do you know these promises? From this verse 1 to 4, that David was religious and extolling the virtues of God. Do you know that these promises, till now, is still subsisting? We have had Jesus Christ and everything has changed. What are the things that God has promised?
Imagine, but if God is with you, it does not matter how many the numbers of people are against you.
many are worried in Nigeria now, I want to assure you, don't worry yourself. No matter the numbers, one by one, we have declared them their locusts. According to the book of Exodus, when locusts invaded the land and Moses, the servant of God, stood, the Bible said, every one of those locusts, they were plucked out by the strong west wind of God and they were thrown into the sea. We decree that the land of Nigeria will swallow every invading locust that is troubling this land in the name of Jesus. I said it last week. I said, according to 1 Samuel 17, 1 Samuel 17, the encounter of David and Goliath. Goliath represented the government of the Philistines. David represented the government of Israel. Say, anyone that defeated, they will become the slave of the other. He opened his mouth and spoke his incantations, called David by his gods. But David opened his mouth and said, you have come to me with a sword and a javelin, but I've come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, whose armies you have defied. The Bible said in verse 51 that David was standing upon the chest of Goliath. Goliath's back was already on the ground. And he used the sword of Goliath to cut his neck. In the name of Jesus, let the anointing of battle, the anointing that made the language of the selfish people who want to take over the entire universe for selfishness, and their languages were multiplied and they were scattered till date. They couldn't find each other. The language of the children of Moab, Ammon and Mount Seir, when they invaded Judah and they said, we are going to take them away as slaves, and God said, I will deal with you. In the name of Jesus, let that anointing come upon every invading alien, everyone brought into Nigeria to trouble the innocent of this land. Let that anointing come upon them. Let them turn against each other like rabid dog and destroy themselves until none of them is standing. In the name of Jesus. Some time ago, I ate something that affected my teeth. So anything kept on getting bad and getting bad. Eventually, I had an elderly friend, Dr. Adetoye Johnson. He loved me, my good Egon. So I said, I wanted to see him. He said, I should come with my wife. My wife wanted to remove a tooth. So when we got there, my wife explained to him and said, this man's teeth have been troubling him, etc. And the man said, let me look at it. When he looked at it, he said, you have to remove it. You have to remove it. To cut a long story short, they put my tooth on that man. He was very sad. I've always been boasting to my wife that me as a Bako child, you know, she was a butter, chocolate baby. So I've always been boasting to her that my teeth will be complete when I go back to see my father. That the whole 32 will remain. Jokingly, but I was speaking the word. That day they pulled out one teeth out of 32. They made it 31. But I've spoken this word to her for years, again and again and again and again. Let me shock you. It was no longer after that. After about 2 months or so, I was just joking one day. My thumb went to that area and I discovered that the teeth started growing. At over 55, teeth was growing. It's not possible. Then we went to see a doctor. He touched, he said, it's like cartilage. This one is not strong. It's not, it's like milk teeth. It can't endure. It will soon be even paining you, troubling you. I say, it's a lie. I say, I told God, I remember I spoke a word. That word has come to pass. He was hitting it with something. He said, can't you feel it? But to cut it on social, that it kept getting stronger and stronger. As I talk to you today, I've been listening to you. To the glory of God's name and to the shame of my enemies. My father, no matter the battle that I am facing or that I will see face, or that is facing Nigeria right now, cover our heads in the day of battle. Open your mouth to pray. Cover my head in the days of battle. Oruwa, Oruwa, bori mi nijo kule. Oni agbara ti asa mi Oruwa, bori mi nijo kule. Cover down my head in the day of battle. In Jesus' name we pray. If you want to pray, speak something good to yourself. Very soon, you begin to see. now. I will move from glory to glory, from success to success. It shall be well with me. Oju ni ti mi, I will not suffer shame. Ah, the enemy will not reproach me in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, every secret enemy around me, Lord, pretending, masquerading as a lamb, as a friend, the Lord will expose all of them. Ah, my glory will not go down in the aftermath of my destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ, my joy shall be fulfilled. My testimony will not be breached. They will not be premature. They will not be aborted. In the name of Jesus, they shall mature. They shall be given. I will laugh my laughter. I will dance my dance. I will rejoice my rejoicing. Nobody will give my testimony in my place. It shall be well with me. My body is made whole. Ah, my head is brilliant. Ah, my eyes will not become dim. The vision of God in my life, the fire of God in my life will not be extinguished. Open your mouth, speak to your destiny. Go ahead and continue to speak. It shall be well with you. And as you say it, it will come to pass. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Once again, and the poor people, he said, any time she lure, so to pray. Your Lord shall pray many, many. It's like loosing your mouth to bandits, to ambulance. He will say thank you to every one of you that supported me for the first segment of the outreach that we had. And it was in the village. It was wonderful. We had everything in excess. By the grace of God, as I said to you, see, actually, we have not collected, but we are going to add more because we are going for the second segment. And there are more in that particular village. By the grace of God, whatsoever that you desire has laid upon your heart, you want to send the cash, you see the account displayed on the platform. You see it, it's scrolled. Whatever you want to do, if you want to send in good scholars, we'll make arrangements, talk about logistics, and see how we're going to make it up. And as you do so, the God who observes and sees secret labels will open and devote you in the public in the name of Jesus Christ. Share will not be a portion. Till I come by your way again.
I really also appreciate all these people that are joining us here to analyze these problems. But if you keep on, if this will help another people to be doing this sort of thing, I think it will be encouraging. So we are so happy. And as many people that will partake on this financing, I pray that next they will take the news out there and tell me about it.
Only you can heal my bones again.
Make it possible for me to achieve this, and I want to say may the Lord Almighty bless them.